Thanks you for watching this presentation. My name is Arnaud Potier. I am working in the XLIM Research Institute in France. And during this talk, I will introduce you the design of high sensitive capacitive sensor that use injection lock oscillator to achieve PPM sensing resolution. This development was done by Ms. Mesa Babé during her PhD work in collaboration with the IHP Research Center in Germany. This is the outline of the talk. After a short introduction, we will see how CMOS technology can be very helpful to develop novel Lavon chips analysis system with advanced electronic embedded, especially original dielectric capacitive sensor operating at microwave frequency with the frequency with the capability to detect few attofarad capacitance change we represent. We will see how we have designed such sensing system, and we will discuss about the main experimental result we obtained on first prototype before going to conclusion. Dielectric sensor, especially the one operating at microwave frequency, can find a wide range of application, notably for medical diagnosis, to be used, for example, for biological cells analysis or for various infections. Other applications can be found in the frame of the food safety control, or even to analyze ambient air in order to detect toxic gases. Numerous capacitive sensors have been reported in the literature. Here you could find few examples, as this one used to characterize dielectric properties of single biological cells. This is a purely passive capacitor implemented inside a microfluidic channel that is able to detect hundreds of attofarad capacitance change. Other design, other application, here for gas sensing, for which a system of differential capacitor is used. You have one capacitor used as a reference and the other as detector. Which capacitance is covered with a sensitive material that is that has is dielectric property which could vary with specific gas molecule absorbed. We see that such device can achieve a detection resolution in the range of few hundred of attofarad. In this other example, this is the dependence of the dielectric properties of a polyimide material related to moisture level, which allow to monitor hygrometry with a quite good sensitivity. Here, you have another approach where the change of shape of a deformable diaphragm embedded in a CMOS layer stack is measured thanks to a capacitance change monitoring with such with sub femtofarad sensing sensitivity. All these approaches, in fact, use the principle of measuring the change of a sensor capacitance due to a dielectric disturbance. A disturbance induced, in fact, by the targeted physical parameter to monitor. Now, the question is how to go further the only few hundreds of attofarad detection sensitivity and reach now the attofarad sensing resolution. To address this challenge, we have chosen to take advantage of CMOS technology and its ability to integrate on the same chip in the neighborhood on the main sensor, some microwave sources, as well as all the electronic needed to control the sensor. CMOS also allows to have a deep miniaturization of the whole system, as well as a co-integration with other technology, as for example, microfluidics. And so now it is possible to imagine to develop real Lavon chip systems with their advanced electronics fully embedded. In this work, our objective was to develop a very high sensitivity sensor using CMOS technology a sensor able to operate close to 5 GHz with few attofarad detection capability. To address such challenge, we will have to ensure a very high measurement accuracy in order to finally evaluate the dielectric property change of the material to sense. For that, we have chosen to develop a detection system based on an oscillator architecture. When you use an oscillator as a detector, you have to face two major constraints. One is the stability of the oscillation frequency, meaning that if the oscillator presents too much jitter in frequency, it will be very difficult to ensure a high detection accuracy. The second point is the spectral purity of the oscillator. Indeed, we are not in the ideal world, and we will not achieve to obtain a signal looking as a perfect Dirac in the frequency domain. The sensor will suffer from noise coming from its operating environment. It could be thermal noise, electronic noise, but this noise could degrade deeply its detection capability, especially if our oscillator presents a large peak. It will not be usable if we aim to detect frequency shift as small as few tenths of kilohertz around 5 GHz. We understand well that a fine peak with a low noise close to the carrier will be much more favorable to address such challenge. That is why we propose here to use the principle of injection locked oscillator in order to reduce the phase noise figure near the carrier. If we consider an oscillator implemented on a chip associated with sensing capacitors, the DSP figures in the frequency domain should look to this one, with a level of phase noise that will mainly rely on the limited quality factor of the sensing element. Now, if we consider a very pure signal provided by an external microwave generator like this one to be used as a reference signal and set at the same frequency that our oscillator, we can notice the much better noise figure here in green. Now, when this source is used as a master oscillator and its signal injected inside our sensing oscillator, we can notice here in blue how the sensor noise figure is greatly improved. So now, what happened when the sensing and the master oscillator present a different but still close oscillation frequency? That will be the case, especially when the sensor will detect the electric perturbation that should result in a small change of its own oscillation frequency. Basically, under injection mode, the slave oscillator will see an improvement of its phase noise figure, but its oscillation frequency will also copy the master oscillator one. In the time domain, if we look at the output signals from both the slave and the master oscillator, we should observe two periodic signals with the same period, but showing a phase shift difference. And this phase shift, if we consider the Adler theory, is in fact directly related to the frequency difference between the master and the sensing oscillation when he was in free running condition. We can see also in this equation that the resulting phase shift can be modulated as function as the injection strength, that in fact depend on the ratio of the signal magnitude between the injected signals and the output signal from the sensing oscillator. Looking to this equation, we can also notice that due to the sinus relationship, we can benefit from an almost linear zone dependence between the measure phase shift and the initial frequency shift between the two signals. So, on the oscillator, master and slave are synchronized, we can reduce the inject signal magnitude in order to increase the slope of this curve, and so to improve the sensor sensitivity and measure a more significant phase shift, especially for our purpose, where the targeted detection sensitivity has to be very high, we will have to favor low injection regime. So, to design our sensing system, we have chosen to use two differential oscillators, one used as a reference and the other as a detector. And both will be locked by the same very low phase noise master oscillator. Hence, by monitoring the induced phase shift between these two injection-locked oscillators, this sensing system should be able to detect a very tiny dielectric disturbance occurring on the detector sensing capacitor with targeted capacitance variation detection as low as few attofarad. Here is presented a schematic view of the system implementation. It uses a LC tank here, formed thanks to a differential inductor set in parallel with a detection capacitor and a MEM capacitor, allowing to make the oscillation occurring close to 5 GHz. This tank is associated with a conventional cross-coupled MOS differential transistor, biased thanks to a current mirror. At the oscillator output is implemented a buffer stage here, allowing to pass from a differential to a single-ended output. And this buffer also allows to connect an oscilloscope and with its 50 ohm input impedance without killing the oscillation. Here you can see a photograph of the chip manufactured by AIHP on their SG25H4 BCMOS technology. We can find on both extremity the LC tank of each oscillator, and in the middle, all the active circuitry required for the master signal injection and output slave oscillator buffering. This chip has been mounted and wire bonded on a PCB board to make easier the connection through this SMA connectors with the different measurements device to be used in our test bench. Here you can see the test bench I'm talking about, in which we use a spectrum analyzer here in order to monitor the sensor running oscillations. You could see here the microwave signal generator used to inject the master signals inside the chip thanks to this balloon. A fast oscilloscope here is used to measure in the time domain the signal coming out the sensing oscillator and monitor its phase shift under injection condition related to the master source signals. For the chip biasing, some batteries were used in order to limit the frequency jitter that generally appear when conventional DC supply sources are used. On the left, you can observe the typical spectrum measure on a sensing oscillator operating at free running conditions. The oscillation frequency is close to 4.7 GHz, and thanks to the use of the battery, the presented noise figure stays reasonable. On the right, one can see how the injection locking improves highly the phase noise figures. Another example here is given where the spectrum of the same oscillator, this time biased with a conventional DC supply, result in much more degraded noise figure. Nevertheless, one can notice that it is all the more interesting here to use the injection lock principle in order to benefit from a deep improvement of the slave oscillator noise figures, and so a deep improvement on the sensor detection capability. Now, on Slowkit, we can play with the injection signal's magnitude, and we recover the Adler theory, predicting that the detection sensitivity can be highly enhanced by lowering the injection signal magnitude, resulting in a strong increase of the slope. As a result, we validate here that using a very low injection magnitude, a shift on a resonator on the sensor frequency related to the master oscillator as low as 10 kHz can be still detected around 4.7 GHz. Hence, for injected signals, power as low as minus 50 dBm, on the scope screen, we can observe that the phase shift of 31 degrees can be measured when the respective frequency of master and sensing oscillator in free running mode are shifted by 100 kHz. If this frequency shift is now reduced to 40 kHz, the measurement phase shift here decreases to 14 degrees. Now, if we consider both reference and detection oscillator, both oscillators are on chip, and both are located by the same master signals. Without any dielectric disturbance on the detection oscillator, no phase shift is induced here, since two oscillator frequencies are the same. Once a small disturbance is introduced on the sensing capacitor, a frequency shift is generated between the two free running oscillator frequencies. And once both locate, this shift is translated in a 13 degree phase shift, as you could see on this screen capture. Now, with an appropriate modeling allowing to know the capacitance variations which originate the considering frequency shift, it is possible to calibrate such sensor. Actually, for the present sensor, we can see on the blue curve that a capacitance change of 3 attofarad around the 670 femtofarad capacitance presented by the wool LC tank should result in a 3-degree phase shift. That should be the minimum phase shift we can consider to be measured confidently. Basically, it means that the effective capacitive sensitivity for such sensor is here 5 ppm, which is quite good. So it's time to me to conclude. We have seen that the proposed design of capacitive sensor based on an injection locked oscillator architecture can be used to detect capacitance change in the range of few attofarad with sensing sensitivity in the ppm range. Such highly sensitive device can be used for a wide range of applications where especially tiny capacitance change are involved, and especially to develop new type of lab on chip systems dedicated to biomedical diagnosis, on which we are currently working on in our laboratories. So I wish to thank the European Commission for its support to this work, especially through the Semcastec project funding. And thank you all for your kind attention. Bye-bye.